Yes, students, I am Sanju Hazriya, Assistant Professor of English at Government College Ratangarh. This is introductory part of the poem The Seven Ages of Man by William Shakespeare. This poem is included in BA Part 1st Paper 1st by Maharaja Ganga Singh University Bikaner. So first of all, introduction of the poet, and William Shakespeare has written this poem. So introduction of William Shakespeare. William Shakespeare was born on 26th April 1564 and died on 23rd April 1616, was an English poet and playwright and actor, widely regarded as the greatest writer in the English language and the world's greatest dramatist. So he is known as the world's greatest dramatist also. He is often called England's national poet and the Bard of Avon. Bard means poet or simply the Bard. His extant works, including collaborations, consists of some 39 plays, 154 sonnets, two long narrative poems and a few other verses, some of uncertain authorship. His plays have been translated into every major living language and are performed more often than those of any other playwright. They also continue to be studied and reinterpreted. Shakespeare was born and raised in Stratford-upon-Avon. So he is known as Bard of Avon. So now you understood why he is known as the Bard of Avon, because he was born and raised in Stratford-upon-Avon, Warwickshire. At the age of 18, he married Annie Hathaway, with whom he had three children, Susan and twins Hamnet and Judith. Sometime between 1585 and 1592, he began a successful career in London as an actor. So he was also writer and actor and part owner of a playing company called the Lord Chamberlain's Men, later known as the King's Men. At age of 49, around 1613, he appears to have retired to Stratford, where he died 3 years later. Few records of Shakespeare's private life survive. This has stimulated considerable speculation about such matters as his physical appearance, his sexuality, his religious beliefs, and whether the works attributed to him were written by others. Shakespeare produced most of his known works between 1589 and 1613. His early plays were primarily comedies and histories and are regarded as some of the best work produced in these genres. He then wrote mainly tragedies until 1608, among them Hamlet, Romeo and Juliet, Othello, King Lear, and Macbeth. These are famous tragedies written by William Shakespeare, all considered to be among the finest works in English language. In the last phase of his life, he wrote tragicomedies. Tragicomedies are also known as romances and collaborated with other playwrights. Now, summary of the poem, and you know today's poem is The Seven Ages of Man. So the poet compares the world to a stage in a theater and men and women to players. So here in this poem, poet is comparing the world to a stage as it is presented in theater and men and women to male players. Each player has his or her exit and entrance. Similarly, men and women enter the world on birth and exit from it on death. They come to this stage, play their different roles and bid goodbye. These parts, acts or stages are normally seven. So, human life is divided into seven parts. The birth of a child is the first act of the drama of human life. The human baby cries and vomits in the nurse's arms. Soon he starts going to school. He has a shining face and carries a bag of books. He goes to school unwillingly, creeping like a snail. This is the second act of his life. The third role that he plays is of a lover. The young lover sighs like a furnace and sings some mournful songs, praising the beauty of his beloved. The fourth stage is that of a soldier. He sports a beard like that of a leopard. He is quick-tempered in matters of honor. He seeks reputation even at the risk of his life. He is not afraid of death and danger while fighting for reputation. However, his reputation is short-lived. It is transitory. It is short-lived. It is hollow like a bubble. So, the reputation is hollow like a bubble. It is transitory. Then comes the middle age. The fifth stage is that of a judge. He is fat with a round and fleshy stomach as a result of eating chickens. He has a beard of formal cut. His eyes are now harsh looking. He becomes strict in his behavior. He uses many sayings and modern instances to support his arguments of wisdom. The sixth stage or the sixth age takes a person to old age. Man becomes weak in health and thin in body. He wears slippers, spectacles, and clothes of his youth. These clothes are now too loose for his shrunk and thin legs. His voice becomes unmanly. He pipes and whistles. He lisps like a child as he is toothless. He looks a comic figure. The last role. Now, the last role of the human life is that of an extremely old person. This act shows him as helpless as a baby. He is toothless, hard of hearing, weak in eyesight, and forgetful. In fact, he loses control over all his senses. He departs from this world after playing these roles of life. So these are the seven roles which a human plays in this whole world, in his life. So I think you understood it and you have already read this poem in your 12th class. So thanks for watching this video.